You know, I'd like to come out here and be the first guy to express to you just how great it is.
Oh, please. Triple H addressing The Undertaker.
I'd like to express just how great it is to have the one true American badass back in the World Wrestling Federation. Welcome home, Undertaker. Welcome home.
Did he say how nice it is to have The Undertaker back?
And I mean, as happy as all of they are that you're back, nobody is happier than me.
I can't believe that. Good reason for that.
No, I really mean that because, after all, you've been back just a short period of time, and hell, already you've done me a huge favor. You see, because at Judgment Day, it was pretty clear I was going to kick The Rock's ass and become the World Wrestling Federation champion again.
Well, that's an arguable point, quite frankly.
But you, my friend, you saved me the effort. I didn't have to do my job myself because you did it for me.
Penny for Rock.
That's right. Rocky, the man that The Undertaker defeated to put the World Wrestling Federation title back where it belongs, around my waist. And Rock, I mean, Taker, I'll tell you, being the kind of man that I am, it's really been bugging me. I mean, I haven't been able to sleep at night knowing that I never got to personally thank you for what you did. And I know you're out here right now to take credit for yourself and blow your own horn, because quite frankly, that's what you do. But let me do it for you. I am out here to publicly thank you for what you did for me and for all the people. Undertaker, thank you very much.
Just how disingenuous is this whole dissertation?
That seemed very sincere to me.
Sure it would.
No, Preston, you need to thank me for not coming down right now and kicking all of your ass. But there's one thing we do need to get straight, and we'll get it straight right now. I don't do anything for anybody except myself.
I knew it was selfish.
Now, any chance from this day forward that I get a chance to slap a knot on any one of you assholes, I'm gonna take it.
And he means it, folks. The Undertaker means it.
His mouth is dirtier than a wicker toilet seat.
And there's one more thing there, Fancy Pants.
Uh-oh.
That belt. Yeah, that belt that's on your shoulder. It belongs to me.
Uh-oh.
The Undertaker.
Uh-oh.
I'll tell you what. You have been gone quite a while, haven't you? But let me fill you in on what's happened since you've been gone. You see, things have changed. And now, when you run your mouth around here, we close it.
Uh-oh.
The only way you're getting close to this belt, pal, is when I shove it down your throat.
The regime surrounding The Undertaker here.
I told you there's strength in numbers, and you're about to see that, JR.
DX Shane.
Mcmahon.
That's The Rock!
What's he doing here now?
The Rock! The Rock has interrupted the proceedings here.
Rock, I don't think this concerns you.
Just as it seemed that the Mcmahon-Hemsley regime was about to pour into the ring and take apart The Undertaker, or at least attempt to do so,
Whoa.
Here we go.
Yeah. I got it now. Oh, this is a real simple picture to see. I see this is what's known as the buddy system, I guess, huh? Yeah, that's what's known as the buddy system. What we have here is we have the Undertaker on Monday night coming to the rescue. Shut up!
Yeah, shut up!
We have the Undertaker coming to the rescue of The Rock on Monday night. That, of course, was after he screwed him out of the title.
Yeah, remember that?
Then on Thursday, we have The Rock coming to the rescue of The Undertaker before the faction kicked his ass.
Hey, that's right.
So it's obvious to me this is a deal whereby The Undertaker scratches your back and Rock, you scratch his, right? Is that what we got?
Buddy system. That's it. Vince figured it out. He's got mental acumen. I think Rock hates to admit it. He hates to admit Vince is right.
No, Vince, this thing between The Rock... Vince, this thing between The Rock and The Undertaker isn't a case of you scratch my back, I'll scratch yours. It's more along the lines of Shane scratches his ass, Triple H kisses your ass, and you sniff a monkey's ass.
What?
And make no mistake about it, any time The Rock has a chance to get his hands on you, Road Dogg, X-Pac, Triple H, Shane, it's a good day. And it becomes an even better day when The Rock can make change out of that $2 walk-in slut, Stephanie.
Wow. Oh, my God. $2? Is that $2 Canadian? You quit it. Don't you start that, too. A beautiful lady.
There ain't no collusion with The Rock and The Undertaker. They ain't buddies, by the way.
Oh, they scratch each other's back.
Because the fact of the matter is this, Vince, is one way or the other, The Rock will do all he can to one day once again become WWF champion.
It couldn't hurt Stephanie's feelings. She's about to cry.
The Undertaker's already declared that.
Oh, okay. I got it. What we have here is two individuals with common enemies. The Mcmahon-Hemsley faction.
That's accurate.
We have two individuals with common goals. They both want to be the WWF champion.
That's exactly right.
Vince is a genius.
So therefore, tonight in Vancouver, in that very ring.
Oh, wait a minute.
Listen to this.
You will not see Triple H defend the WWF title. Oh, no, you're not good enough for that.
Not good enough?
That's right. This is Canada.
But what you will see, one-on-one, since they have so much in common, it'll be The Undertaker, one-on-one with The Rock.
Oh, my God! The Undertaker and The Rock live tonight!
We'll see it, man! If there's a buddy system or not, won't we, JR?
The evil genius, Mr. Mcmahon, has struck again!